Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Glad you could join me. As usual, I'd like to thank all the great people who have subscribed, and I would like to also thank all the new people who have just come along for the journey. Welcome to the journey of building your dream house in Jamaica. Now, as I have said numerously, the idea behind what I'm doing is not to give you a definitive what you must and must not do or what you should and should not do. The idea is to give you an idea that, look, there are other things out there that can be incorporated into your build that can make your build a little bit cheaper, a lot cheaper, or just will in fact end up saving you quite a bit of money. So continuing on with the second part of our two-part series on roofing, we previously spoke about the external material that is used for your roof. Now we are going to talk about the internal material or the frame of the roof, because technically your roof is actually a roofing system and consists of quite a number of parts. Two main parts being the external part that covers your roof and protects your house from rain and moisture, sun, and all of that sort of thing, and the internal section of the roof that holds up all of that sort of stuff. That is a very specific and a very technical part of your build. So when you are doing a normal roof, a what is called a conventional roof, the frame is generally made from wood products, wood or wood products. The frame can also be made from metal, but we are going to sort of ignore that for our purposes because it is not a very common thing in Jamaica and in our tropical condition. Now, there is nothing wrong with metal. It is as strong and in many cases far stronger and more durable than wood. But because it is not commonly used in our situation, we are sort of just going to ignore that and leave that for another time and another episode. But now we are going to concentrate on wood products. Now, in Jamaica here, the frame of your roof will consist of your beams, your trusses, and your rafters, and so on. In our situation, you are going to find that there are two specific types of wood products that you will have available to you, and that will either be engineered wood or it will be milled wood. Now, milled wood is your normal sort of wood, so it's going to be your 2x4, your normal 2x4, 2x6, 1x1, 1x2, whatever it is that is used. On the other hand, you are going to have things like this called your manufactured wood. And why we are talking about those things as a comparison is that in some instances, your manufactured wood is far better. In almost all circumstances, as a matter of fact, your manufactured wood as a product that is used for your roofing is going to be better than your milled wood. The difference is going to be in cost. Now, sometimes the manufactured or engineered wood is cheaper. At other times, your milled wood is going to be cheaper. Now, that is where you will have to do your calculations and decide which one you want. Sometimes, if the engineered wood is more expensive, it does in fact end up being cheaper overall for a number of reasons. First is the engineered wood is a far stronger wood, and your engineered products made from those engineered wood will be more specific to your build. And as a general rule, you will be able to use less of that material. So even if the product itself is more expensive, the fact that you're using less means that you will at the very least have a break-even period. Secondly, many of these engineered wood or engineered wood products are many, many times lighter apart from being much stronger. And as a result of that, you will require less labor for the installation, and that will save a lot in your final cost, in your final build. So those are two areas. Now, a third area in where your engineered wood will in fact shine is the fact that engineered wood tends to stand up a lot better over time than your hewn or dimensional wood. And as a result of that, you will require less maintenance, there will be less rotting, and the integrity of your build will remain much longer. So with that in mind, let me introduce you to the different types of engineered wood products, what they are and how they are made and what they will replace. First up, we have laminated veneer lumber, or LVL, and essentially all that is just plywood. So a normal log is essentially peeled in the normal way that you would peel a normal log when you're making plywood. This is then glued together under high pressure, and many pieces are glued together running in essentially the same direction. Now the advantage of this is that the fibers of the wood all go in the same direction, but knots and weaknesses in the wood are randomized, and because it is now put together under high pressure and then cut board size, which you would get something like your 2x4, 2x2, and any normal size wood that you would normally get from your dimensional lumber, you can get that. You could cut those same sizes from your LVL. What you do end up with is an engineered product that is more than 3 or 4 times as strong as your dimensional wood product. This final product, of course, can be used anywhere that you would normally use your dimensional wood product. Parallel strand lumber is the next well-known and extremely well-engineered wood, and that is made simply by taking a normal log, ripping it apart into strands, usually about 1/4 inch around or so, and usually about 6 or so feet long. These are then laid parallel to each other, impregnated with glue and other chemicals, and then reintegrated under high pressure. So the difference between the LVL and the PSL is that the LVL is shaved in strips and then laid together in sheets, and the PSL is put together essentially like a bundle of straws that is glued together. That is then cut into your dimensions, your normal dimensions, as you would cut normal wood. And again, what you do end up with is an extremely strong product, something that is much stronger than what you could get using your dimensional wood. The other product is your oriented strand board. Oriented strand board is essentially particle board using very large particles. Now, how this one works is that the strands are cut into more or less flat pieces of wood, usually around about 1 inch, 2 inches long by about 1/2 inch or so wide. They are generally oriented in a specific direction. Then a sheet of that is glued together under high pressure. These sheets are then turned diagonal to each other, usually at a 90 degree angle to each other, in the manner that you would normally orient plyboard. And again, these individual sheets of oriented strand board are glued together to build up a sheet of whatever dimension you wish to have, whether or not it be 1/4 inch, 1/2 inch, 1 inch, 1.5 inches, and so on and so forth. Now, these various engineered products are then used together to make things like trusses and rafters, beams, and so on. A truss that is put together in this manner tends to be very light and can be used to span extremely long distances and still maintain their integrity, and that is why they are far better in many cases than your dimensional wood or your sawn lumber. Now, as I said, this is by no means an exhaustive list, and the point of what I'm doing here is simply to get you to understand that there are choices to be made, and for you to ask questions when your engineer, contractor, or your architect put forward a plan. You have the knowledge to ask the important questions that might be relevant to your build. So again, we would like to say thanks for watching. We'd like to say thank you to all the new people who have subscribed. Do not forget to like and subscribe the videos. And if you like the videos, just hit the like button. It helps the channel out. Also, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, because then you will get everything that I post, and also hit the notification bell so you will be notified whenever I put out something new. So as usual, thanks for watching, and you all have a good day.